Hi everybody, this is Patsy and it is Thursday, Terrific Tutorials. And today we're going to be, I'm going to be demoing how to fume silver glass. How to use fine silver and use it for fuming. So this is a bead that I did, and I used the dark ivory on it, and I used a opaque red, and then a transparent blue. And it's I'll demo this one and that two different colors, okay? So you can kind of see how it has a beautiful silver fuming on it, and then what it did to the dark ivory. Okay, and I want to point out that you should be using a mask when you're doing any kind of fuming, because the minerals go into the air, and when you breathe them, they'll make you sick. And so you want to use a mask. And what I use, it's M7502. It's a 3M company, and it is a higher quality plastic, probably silicon. And if you get the lower quality, they don't hold up as well. And when you wear this, you need to always clean it, because your skin puts off oils and it deteriorates this. And if you buy the cheaper brands, it will make this sticky, and you know, it's worthless after using it for a while. So always, after you use it, clean it good. And this is the filter, and it's for minerals like silver and gold and any kind of fuming that you would be doing. So it's the 2091 P100. Okay, so that I use this when I fume. And the next thing we're going to do is I'm going to be using, this is fine silver. And this is about the thickness of a 22 gauge. It doesn't really matter how the thickness. It's just, this is nice to use, because then you could even, if you're making a bead, you can incorporate it. It's fine enough that you can incorporate it into your bead as well. And I always leave the tag on it, so I never get, I got this from Rio Grande, but I always leave the tag on it that lets me know that it's fine silver. And make sure you pull off enough, because this gets hot really, really fast. So you don't want to hold your hands near this part of it. And I'm using a borosilicate glass rod, thicker. And that way, otherwise, if you use just regular Moretti glass or the soft glass, excuse me, it will it'll get too soft, and the glass won't hold its form, because you're going to be sticking it underneath the flame and into the flame a little bit. So you need a harder glass. Okay. So basically, you heat your borosilicate up a little bit. So when you heat your silver, your fine silver, it'll attach to it, and then you just heat up a little ball of it and just drop it on. And then you heat up the borosilicate again to make sure it's nice and attached to it. Okay, so I'm going to heat up a little bit more and drop it on. Okay, and this stays hot for a while, so make sure you have it in a place that you're not going to stick your hands on it. Okay, so I'm just making sure it's attached really, really good, and I'm going to lay it aside. And I'm going to make my bead, and we're going to use the dark ivory, Moretti, or any kind of glass, soft glass that has a nice reduction tendency to it. And I'm just going to ball up some, and I'm going to do this part first, and then we'll put the second color on after we reduce this color. Well, not reduce it, but to fume it. Okay? Otherwise, well, you'll see what happens. So we got a neutral flame, and I'm just putting some on. And I'm going to, I like to make sure you get a lot of area space when you're working with your fuming. You know, if you just have a tiny little area, it's kind of wasting the effect of the fuming. Okay, so here we go. And what you do is, I extended the, what is this? Propane? Or is that oxygen?
Oxygen.
That's oxygen. So I am making my flame, I'm making my flame larger by turning my oxygen down. So the propane is more to create the flame. So basically just create about an inch and a half flame. And you don't want to overheat your glass, okay? You want to keep it a little bit on the cooler side. And you just go underneath the flame. And you'll be, and keep your bead at the very end of the flame, just where it's kind of licking the flames on the very end, and just stick your silver into underneath the flame until you'll see, here we go, see that color, see that change? It's the silver has become a vapor, and it's traveling along the flame. I'm taking the bead out because it was getting too hot. So, and then things to be careful about is, like, I have a large ball of silver. So that, when it heats up and gets molten, it will fall off and drip off. So be careful. Don't keep, you know, it's better. See how I have an angle? If I go straight under and some of that molten silver drips off, it could drip on your skin. So you want to keep your borosilicate glass on an angle. And okay, and glass bead is cool enough. We're gonna do it again. And I got it at the end of the flame, and just slowly, here you see how the color changes, and the silver is moving all the way down the flame as a fume, as a vapor. And because it's on the end, it just picks up that silver. Okay, so let me do it one more time so you can see. I'm letting my bead cool again. And then I put it in towards the back, and I stick that silver. And the flame actually changes colors. And you can see that silver flowing. And then it attaches. But you can tell, even though I'm fuming it, there's, and the end of it is catching the silver, there is more vapor. And that's why you wear that mask. Okay, now I'm going to cut the... I'm going to make the oxygen stronger to make it back into a neutral flame. And we're going to heat. Now, if you wanted to, you could have left it like that. But I want to get that marbly, that, I don't know what you call it, webbing on my darks ivory. So I'm just going to heat it up. Let me just heat it up. And what will happen is that silver will create that, that silver will create that beautiful webbing effect. So here, let's take a look at it on the side so you can see how beautiful. Now, my webbing is really dark because we put so much silver on it. You know, the fuming is so you, it's up to you to how many times you want to do that silver fuming. Initially it'll be lighter, and the more you do it, the darker it'll get. Okay, and let me show you now. I'm just using, this is just an orangey kind of carrot. I think it's the carrot color in the Moretti glass. All right. And just going to heat it up, and I'm going to add it to the end of it. And now, if you fume the carrot color, and you get the fuming, that silver fuming on your dark ivory, what's going to happen is you're going to lose some of that webbing effect, and it'll get your dark ivory will get darker again, just for the fact that while I'm fuming this, some of the fuming will go to that dark ivory too. So that's why I'm putting it pretty much, you know, as far away from the dark ivory as I can. Okay, so get this a little bit better. Not that I have a lot of time here. Okay, and we're going to fume again. So we're making it more propane in the flame, and we're getting it about 1.5 inches. And I'm gonna make sure your bead is you don't want it molten or anything like that. You just want it fairly warm, but not glowing. And then you stick that silver underneath and slowly into the flame until you see it fuming. Okay, and there it goes. Isn't that gorgeous? So it can go really fast. And so we'll take a, let me cut that off. And so you can see how beautiful that is. And that's the red. And when it cools, it'll go back to that other color. So I'll take a picture of this and put it in my blog post as well. So there you go. There is silver fuming with fine silver. It's got to be fine silver. Hope you enjoy this, and be sure to like and share my blog post and my videos. I really appreciate it. And take some time and check out my tutorials. I have 5 different tutorials that you might enjoy, and check out my beads too. Appreciate it. Everything that I've really been enjoying, everybody's feedback, and be sure to comment and let me know what you'd like to learn about next. I was thinking about doing some encasing with these silver, so let me know if that would be something y'all would like to hear about. Okay, so have a great day. Bye.